Hi everyone, this is a short video of making a poor man's spindle load meter using an ammeter and voltmeter. A subsequent video will use power meters. The voltmeter is attached in parallel and the ammeter is attached in series. Since these are unshielded meters, care should be taken to dress the ammeter wires following the meter's instructions. While this load measurement is qualitative because of non-linearity between current and motor power, the estimate is still useful. For a 1 horsepower brushless DC motor supplied with 120 volt, assuming optimistic efficiency, the expected current draw of the spindle motor at full load is roughly 6.25 amp. Here a 3-inch aluminum part is being faced with a fly cutter, 50 thou depth of cut, 2500 RPM, and a feed rate of 10 inches per minute. The current meter suggests we are near full load. Most operations that I do barely budge the needle. However, while drilling with a 1/2-inch drill bit, the meter jumped to 15 amp. I didn't notice the indicated speed, but the spindle motor sounds to be struggling. I hit the e-stop and reduced the feed rate. Without the power meter, I would have kept going, potentially doing damage. The G-code to cut the front panel was prepared in Fusion 360. A summary of tools and operations can be generated by Fusion 360, and this is a great place to write additional notes, including performance observations. The stock material is 1/4-inch plywood, cut to size on a table saw and held to a sacrificial piece of MDF with double-sided tape. First, screw holes are drilled, and a few will be used to help hold the stock in place. The last operation is 2D pocketing with multiple depths of cut with a 1/2-inch end mill to cut holes for the meters. Given the cost of quality hole saws, having a CNC mill to cut panel holes is nice. With light sanding, the part cleaned up nicely. The side facing MDF was pretty clean. A vacuum attachment might be nice. Thanks for watching.